late, Coop.
Yeah, we had a flat.
It's an Indian surveillance drone. Solar cells power an entire farm.
What'd you do, Murph?
She didn't do nothing.
Murphy's Law.
You're a well-educated man, Coop. And a trained pilot.
And an engineer.
The world doesn't need any more engineers. We didn't run out of planes and television sets. We ran out of food.
Dad, why did you name me after something that's bad?
Oh, we didn't.
Murphy's Law.
Murphy's Law doesn't mean that something bad will happen. It means that whatever can happen will happen.
We must confront the reality that nothing in our solar system can help us.
Now you need to tell me what your plan is to save the world.
We're not meant to save the world. We're meant to leave it. And this is the mission we were trained for.
I've got kids, Professor.
Get out there and save them.
You have no idea when you're coming back.
I'm coming back.
We must reach far beyond our own lifespans. We must think not as individuals, but as a species. We must confront the reality of interstellar travel.
Murph, I love you
forever.
Hello.
Is he asking me on a date?
She didn't seem that impressed. Wow.
You clean up pretty good yourself.
You two look fine this evening.
We're on a date.
Very nice.
Took you long enough to ask. So, why did you give up your life on Earth? We boarded the Avalon with a destination. 120 years hibernation means a wake up in a new century on a new planet. But a year ago, everything changed.
Hello? Anybody here?
Hello? Do you know what's going on? Nobody else is awake.
I think something went wrong with the hibernation pods. We woke up too soon. 9 years too soon.
This can't be happening. We have to go back to sleep.
We can't.
Aurora, we love you!
Something's wrong. Something big.
What do we do now?
Do you trust me? This ship is gonna go. I have to do this.
No! You die, I die!
There's something I have to tell you. There's a reason we woke up early.
think you can't make mistakes. But the choices you make could get yourself and everyone under your command killed. But I believe in you, Jim.
Darkness is coming.
This could just be the beginning.
Beginning of what?
All-out war. I request permission to go after him. I cannot allow you to do this.
Jim, you're not actually going after this guy, are you?
Let's go get this son of a bitch.
You are a pawn, Kirk.
Sir, there's a ship heading right for us.
You can't even guarantee the safety of your own crew. Now, shall we begin?
I'm sorry.
We're outnumbered. Outgunned.
I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. I only know what I can do.
The ship's dead, sir. She's gone.
No, she's not.
Ship should go down without her, Captain.
I believe in you, Jim.
When I found you, I saw raw, untamed power. And beyond that, something truly special.
Has always been there. But now it's awake. And I need help.
I've seen this raw strength only once before. It didn't scare me enough then. It does now.
Die. Kill it. If you have to. That's the only way to become what you were meant to be.
My place in all this.
Every human being has a basic instinct to help each other out. If a hiker gets lost in the mountains, people coordinate a search. If an earthquake levels the city, people all over the world send emergency supplies. This instinct is found in every culture, without exception.
At around 4:30 a.m., our satellites detected a storm approaching the Ares III mission site on Mars. The storm had escalated to severe, and we had no choice but to abort the mission. But during the evacuation, astronaut Mark Watney was killed.
I'm entering this log for the record. This is Mark Watney, and I'm still alive, obviously. I have no way to contact NASA or my crewmates, but even if I could, it would take 4 years for another manned mission to reach me, and I'm in a hab designed to last 31 days. So, in the face of overwhelming odds, I'm left with only one option. I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this. Okay, let's do the math. I gotta figure out how to grow 4 years worth of food here on a planet where nothing grows. But if I can't figure out a way to make contact with NASA, none of this matters anyway.
Houston, be advised. We've got a video message. It's directed to the whole crew. Play it.
Mein Gott. Mark Watney's still alive.
Woo! In your face, Neil Armstrong.
We left him behind.
Let's go get our boy. This is something NASA rejected, so we're talking mutiny. And if we mess up the supply rendezvous, you die. If we mess up the Earth gravity assist, we die.
It's space. It doesn't cooperate. I guarantee you that at some point, everything's gonna go south on you. And you're gonna say, this is it. This is how I end.
Is it possible that he's still alive?